Hello dear students, myself Mrs. Pallavi Bamne, Department of Biology. We'll be dealing with the next topic from ecology, that is loss of biodiversity and causes. Here, first let us see what biodiversity is. Biodiversity is the occurrence of different types of genes, gene pools, species, habitats and ecosystem in a particular place and various parts in the planet. This biodiversity term was coined by Edward Wilson. It is very doubtful if any new species are being added through speciation into the Earth's treasury of species. There is no doubt about their continuing losses. The biological wealth of our planet has been declining rapidly, and the accusing finger is clearly pointing to the human activities. The colonization of tropical Pacific islands by humans is said to have led to the extinction of more than 2,000 species of native birds. Here, the IUCN Red List 2004 documents the extinction of 784 species are extinct, including 338 vertebrates, 359 invertebrates and 87 plants in the last 500 years. Some of the examples of recent extinctions include the dodo from Mauritius, koga from Africa, thylacine from Australia, Steeler sea cow from Russia, and the three subspecies, that is Bali, Javan and Caspian of tiger. So these are the three tiger species have become extinct. Since the last 20 years have witnessed the disappearance of 27 species. Now, the careful analysis of records shows that extinctions across the taxa are not random. Some groups like amphibians appear to be more vulnerable to the extinctions. Adding to the grim scenario of extinctions is the fact that more than 15,500 species worldwide are facing the threat of extinction. Presently, 12% of all bird species, 23% of all mammal species, 32% of all amphibian species and 31% of all gymnosperm species in the world face the threat of extinction. From a study of the history of life through fossil records, we learn that large-scale loss of species like the one we are currently witnessing have also happened earlier. During the long period, more than 3 billion years since the origin and diversification of life on Earth, where five episodes, we call it as mass extinction of species. Now, let us see how is the sixth extinctions presently in progress different from the previous episodes. The difference is in the rates. The current species extinctions rates are estimated to be 100 to 1000 times faster than in the pre-human times, and our activities are responsible for the faster rates. Ecologists warn that if the present trends continue, nearly half of all the species on Earth might be wiped out within the next 100 years. In general, loss of biodiversity in a region may lead to, first, decline in plant production, lowered resistance to environmental perturbations such as drought, increased variability in certain ecosystem processes such as plant productivity, water use, pest and diseases cycle. Now, what this biodiversity depletion is? Biodiversity depletion is the reduction or loss of plants and animal species is called biodiversity depletion. So what is happening because of this depletion? Clearing of forests and conversion of agricultural lands for human habitation has a direct impact on biodiversity, as it is directly destroying the natural habitat, eliminating very important plants and animal species. Now, this is about the biodiversity. Now let us see what are the causes for biodiversity loss. So there are major four causes for biodiversity loss. One, habitat loss and fragmentation, overexploitation, alien species invasions, and the fourth, co-extinctions. Let us see one by one. That is, first one is habitat loss and fragmentation. This is most important cause driving animals and plants to extinction. The most dramatic examples of habitat loss come from the tropical rainforest. Earlier, covering more than 14% of the Earth's land surface, these rainforests now cover more than 6%. They are being destroyed fast. So earlier 14% were there, land surface were, rainforest was being destroyed, but now around 6%. By the time you finish reading this chapter, 1000 more hectares of rainforest would have been lost. The Amazon rainforest, which is so huge and called the lungs of the planet, harboring millions of species, is being cut and clear for cultivating soybeans. When large habitats are broken into smaller fragments due to various human activities, mammals and birds requiring large territories, certain animals with migratory habits are badly affected, leading to the population declines. So this was the first cause. Next, overexploitation. Now, what is overexploitation? Humans have always depended on nature for food and shelter. But when need turns to greed, it leads to overexploitation of natural resources. Many species extinctions in the last 500 years, take for example, steller sea cow, passenger pigeon, these were due to the overexploitation by humans. Presently, many marine fishes around the world are over-harvested, endangering the continued existence of some commercially important species. Next, the third cause is alien species invasions. When alien species are introduced unintentionally or deliberately, for whatever purpose, some of them turned invasive and cause decline of indigenous species. Take for example, the Nile perch, introduced into the Lake Victoria in East Africa, led eventually to the extinction of an ecologically unique assemblage of more than 200 species of chichilid fish in the lake. You must be familiar with the environmental damage caused and threat posed to our native species. Invasive weed species like carrot grass, which is called as Parthenium, Lantana, and water hyacinth, which is called as Icornia. The recent illegal introduction of the African catfish, Clarias gallipinus, for aquaculture purpose is posing a threat to the indigenous catfish in our rivers. So the last cause is co-extinction. When a species becomes extinct, the plants and animal species associated with it in an obligatory way also become extinct. When a host fish species become extinct, its unique assemblage of parasites also meets the same fate. Another example is the case of a co-evolved plant pollinator mutualism, where extinction of one invariably leads to the extinction of the other. So these are the causes of biodiversity loss. With this, I will conclude here. Thank you.